So the Holy Spirit would like to discourse and speak about the integrity of nature. Everything in the universe is integrated as one, as we know. And when we enter into the integrated state of oneness with the divine, we can manifest our true reality. When we attune to nature and its infinitude and its blessed state of beingness, everything in our world becomes enlightened, rarefied, energized, activated, and spiritualized to the point where we feel that connectedness. We feel the harmony first within ourselves, and then as we attune to nature, we feel it within all of nature, which is really one being. When we are in one beingness, the similitude of God, which is the simple joy of beingness, manifests. When you are expressive of your true nature through being one with your source, you walk in the light. You walk lightly and you walk in the light, and everything becomes self-evident in your world. You know who you are. You know your source. You know your destiny. You feel by walking the path that through this connectedness, everything in a pure joy field and a stream of heart-centeredness is alive. Everything around you is so rarefied in this aliveness. It takes on new dimensions of crystallized light, because as you walk in that light, you experience that light in all of its aspects. The harmony of it, the beauty of it, the blessedness of it, the glory of it. When we are glorified in the presence of the one Spirit, the one eternal Spirit, the Holy Spirit, the Great Spirit, our lives become sublime. There's no more struggle, strain, or stress. There's no more reactivity. In harmony, lack of peace, there is perfect reverence for life. Reverence for life within ourself, deep within our heart. Reverence for life within the heart of every creature. Reverence for life within every culture, every people, every plant, animal, mineral, every angel, archangel, divine being. This reverence keeps us in a state of perfect oneness. When you walk lightly upon the earth as the native peoples have, and as many of us did in past lives, as those who were completely connected to Mother Earth, you know the continuity of life through all cultures, the elders, their teachings, their wisdom, the mothers who are the repository of culture itself. Yes, the tribal leaders, the elders as the chieftains, shared their wisdom in the circles. And there was a great sharing within the circle of the ancient teachings and wisdom and lore. However, the mothers were the repository of the culture itself, because they carried within their ovum the essence of the Divine Mother, the creator of the entire universe. Without the Divine Mother as the universe itself, we would not exist. With the Divine Mother front and center in our lives as Mother Nature, we can ascertain her wisdom by communing with her every day in some way, both simple and great, through stillness, silence, and meditation, yet also through working in our gardens, walking in the forests as we have today, communing with elemental life, the beautiful, beautiful nature spirits that both inhabit these sacred spaces and guard and protect them, yet they also utilize the energies vouchsafed to the earth by the Divine Mother to maintain an ongoing co-creation. Creation didn't stop after the first seven epochs or days. Co-creation is ongoing through us, and the Holy Spirit helps us to be true co-creators. What are we co-creating each day? That's the question we can ask when we arise in the morning. Am I a co-creator in the highest sense with my beloved, my divine source? Am I allowing the Holy Spirit to guide every step? Am I allowing the Holy Spirit to speak through me, to muse through me, to share through me, to inspire, enlighten, and empower through me? These three terms, empower, enlighten, and inspire, are the threefold flame of the Holy Spirit's sacred work that has been vouchsafed to us as sons and daughters of the One Eternal God or Source. And when we choose to empower, enlighten, and inspire others by our example, by our love, by our wisdom, and by the truth that is spoken through our sacred words, then we carry that original seed of the Father and egg of the Mother into the co-creative world of the future within each moment, within the eternal now. So now feel the sacredness of this place. Go deep into the earth in your consciousness and absorb the essence of Mother Earth as she adores us, even as we revere her. You know, the Divine Mother adores us. Your mother adored you as a child. How can the Earth Mother, do anything other than adore every one of her children, every being that exists and coexists with her upon this sacred planet? So if the Divine Mother adores us, we can at least revere her womb and her being and her essence within nature and upon the earth, and treat the earth with complete respect and reverence. We can utilize the resources of the earth righteously and judiciously, and through permaculture principles understand the givingness that we are a part of, which is the givingness of the Divine Mother. The All Buddha, who is the one who shares the wisdom of the Divine Mother, has embodied through many lineages, which are streams of wisdom, ancient and even for today. And you, as budding Buddha beings, whether you're Christian, Muslim, Jew, or Buddhic, or Taoist, or doesn't matter, a native person, or no religion at all, just a spirit being or a spirit spark, you have that essence etched within you, within your heart, within your mind, within your will, and especially within your soul, to give birth each day to what the Divine Mother would hatch through you as a God-conscious solar being in the becoming. So through our teaching on the human aura, the advanced studies, we know that we are all offspring of the sun and that we are becoming suns, S-U-N-S, sons of God, by being clothed with light, by being fully emblazoned in that light that we accept into our being through all of our spiritual practices, and just through joy, through our aliveness, through our love, love of our family, love of our partner, love of each other, love of the earth, love of everything. When we have love, there is no differentiation or compartmentalization of that love into this is my love for you, or this is my love for that, or this person. Love is love. It is what co-creates, it is what sustains the universe, it is the essence of the universe itself. So when we now come before this beautiful heart image, etched by nature, and placed here for God-conscious ones who come at the behest of our beautiful, very wise elder, Julie Ryder, we feel the aliveness of this heart that we are now a part of and that we will always remember on this sacred day, the 19th of June 2019. So, 6/19/19. We've been waiting for this day for eons. We've chosen to embody in these bodies at this time to perform alchemy, to accomplish our divine plan, our sacred mission, and to fulfill our holy purpose. Each of us has such a sacred purpose that if you knew how sacred your purpose is, your mission in this life, you would be in awe of yourself. Your divine self, of course, but even your human self. So get in awe of who you truly are and live in that heart-centered state, which is the perfected state of love. There is no better perfected state of beingness than to be in love with life, in harmony with that love 24/7, to let love lead you, to let love encourage you, to let love mold you and remold you again and again. And sometimes love can be tough too. You know, we have to be disciplined by the Divine Mother, who at times comes because we maybe not be on schedule, or we're a little behind in our learning. So the Divine Mother will impel you sometimes and maybe, you know, cause something to happen that will move you a little quicker into alignment with the stars and your divine purpose and the cycles that you vowed before you came into embodiment to fulfill. So this has all been orchestrated. You chose your parents, you chose one another. We all chose each other as our beautiful heart friends, as we say in our activity. And the love that we share, the love that we experience in our togetherness, in our oneness, can't really be defined other than that it is part of the greater stream or heart stream of God, right? It is a sacred heart stream of beingness. So as we now fulfill the rest of this journey today, as we walk back, you know, maybe seeing the last sacred spot and then to our cars, let us consciously send rays of love deep from our feet and our chakras into the earth to bless it and to thank the earth, the Divine Mother, for this beauty, this amazing architecture of the ancients, 72,000 and more years ago. Think of that. You know, it's been 78 months since we were in Peru and Lake Titicaca, 78, 6.5 years. So at the end of this year, it'll be a 7-year cycle since we were there. What have we done in 6.5 years? We've done a lot together. We've danced the panarrhythmy with Boris and all over the world. We've danced the panarrhythmy all over the world. And we're going to dance it on our property tomorrow morning. You better be there or be square. It's 7:30 in the morning. So get a good night's sleep.
7 and or 7:30?
7:30.
Okay.
Yeah. And Boris is going to lead us. And make sure you're all wearing white. We will always remember Julie Ryder. Mm. The mission she has had is phenomenal, to bring all of these teachings and understandings from so many cultures and ages and epochs. And, you know, she's this nexus of just like cosmic information. And we have to pray for her. We have to pray for her protection. We have to pray for her you know, her mission to be completed. She's got some years left, I hope.
I've seen my death, and this isn't it.
Yeah. And I don't think this is the last time we're going to be communicating. So.
And you're all welcome back here. Please come back.
So let's give a round of applause to our beloved team.
Thank you.
And I'm just on fire with spiritual light. And I hope you feel both the presence of the Holy Spirit and the love. So thank you all. Namaste.